Hey folks, welcome at this English summary. It's a very long story to make a summary of. So I think the best way of doing this is just focus on the main, main things we discussed with Robbie. Robbie is the guy who has restored the Nashorn. Well, I have to tell first, the Nashorn has been on exposition at Overloon War Museum. And the Nashorn is a German tank hunter. The undercarriage is based of Panzer III, Panzer IV vehicles. It has a 80-80mm cannon. It's a PAK 43. Yeah, PAK 43 gun. And it's very rare. There are only three left in the world. They built around 500 of these, a little bit less, but only three are left. One is in the USA, one is in Russia, and one is in the Netherlands. Robbie and his team, they restored this vehicle, but they had a really bad terugval and terugslag, tegenslag.
An accident.
Yeah, they had an accident. The workshop burned to the ground with the vehicle in it. So they restored it the second time. So that's a really great job they did. The vehicle was on exposition in Overloon, and it will be transported this day back to their workshop because they need to finish it. There are a lot of details they want to finish. But we had the time to look around the vehicle and to see all the details. It's a very long story, of course, and I can't remember it all to make a summary of this. That's undoable. But we can mention some of the main parts, of course. They did not install the original engine anymore. There was a Maybach V12, 12 liters, I believe. Yeah, it's 12 liters. But now they have this Dutch engine, diesel, air-cooled. And it's also a V12. They also used a different gearbox and also the steering hub from FV432 vehicle. Yeah, that's an armored personal carrier. So they used different parts to get this thing actually driving again. Then we looked at the outside. There were some damages, some battle scars. There was even part of a bullet at the backside, where you have the Balkenkreuz, the German marks. Right in the German mark is still a bullet inside, and also the side plate. There were bullet holes from the inside to the outside, so it looked like the vehicle had been attacked from the air by a plane, and it had some damages by machine gun fire, probably shooting at the crew inside the vehicle, of course. Okay, I think I've mentioned the most important things. After that, they started the vehicle and they drove it outside and loaded it onto the trailer. And that's about it. If you want to see more about this project, you can check the links we have below the video, because the Nashorn project also makes its own videos, and they are in English. So it might be interesting. You can check it out. They're also on Facebook. So excellent. I would say thank you for watching, and see you next time.